Alaskan Malamute versus Siberian Husky. These are large, powerful breeds that can be a lot to handle, but can also prove to be great companions. Both have similar appearances, but Huskies are generally social, smaller, and tend to live a little longer. Whereas the Malamute is more loyal, protective, and was originally bred to pull heavy weights. The Alaskan Malamute versus Siberian Husky debate is a battle of the titans between two breeds that have worked alongside humans for a long time. So which one is better? Let's discuss in this video. So if you are ready, be sure to grab some popcorn and watch till the end. If you don't want to miss our videos, please do subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell to get notified every time we post new videos. History in harsh climates. Both breeds originated in climates of extreme and unforgiving cold, but one hails from northern Asia and the other from closer to home. The key is in the name. The Siberian Husky, who ranks 14th among AKC recognized breeds in popularity, comes from Siberia. The Alaskan Malamute, which ranks 58th, originated in Alaska. Similarities. Alaskan Malamutes and Siberian Huskies were both developed as working dogs for cold, snowy climates. Hence their thick, double-layer coats consisting of a straight outer coat and dense undercoat. They're also pretty alike when it comes to behavior, training needs, and communication. Plus, do they require a lot of dedicated training and a lot of love? But they also give a lot of love in return. Both the Alaskan Malamute and the Siberian Husky are devoted to their owners and friendly dogs. They can have an independent nature, so both benefit from early socialization and obedience training. Temperament. Both the Alaskan Malamute and the Siberian Husky were bred to work in packs of dogs and live alongside their masters and family. Both of these pups are very loving and affectionate with their pack. And once they have settled down for the evening after a fun-filled day, they will jump on the sofa with you and demand attention, strokes, and cuddles. However, the Malamute tends to be more aloof with strangers or those he hasn't accepted as one of the pack yet. On the other hand, the Husky is particularly sociable and will accept other humans and animals alike. The Husky is also known to be a dopey derp of a dog who will bring hours of laughter. It is for this reason that the Husky has been known to suffer from separation anxiety and does not like to be left at home on his own for too long. Due to this difference in their sociality, the Malamute has increased guarding tendencies compared to the Husky, and therefore Malamutes can often make good guard dogs. The Malamute has a high prey drive and a low tolerance for other animals, particularly other dogs, whereas the Husky also has a high prey drive but is tolerant and social with other animals. For this reason, the Siberian Husky rarely makes a good guard dog, as he thinks that everyone just wants to play, which is great for the family but not much of a deterrent for would-be intruders. So, this makes them a more suitable pet for a young family or a family with other pets. Energy. When it comes to exercise, these guys are very similar. They both need lots and lots of it. They will both need at least 90 minutes of activity per day. But this shouldn't just be a 90-minute walk. They need to burn off some serious steam with intense exercise. This could be tug of war, frisbee, or even dog agility courses, to name but a few. They also both benefit from being off leash and allowed to run to their heart's content, given that they are both sled dogs. They are both working dogs who were built to run miles at a time without tiring, and this want for work is innate and can never be trained out of them. If they do become bored, they will destroy anything they can get their paws on. This is the main reason Malamutes and Huskies are put up for rehoming more so than the average breed, simply because their owners completely underestimate their need for exercise. If you can't give them the activity they need, then neither of these breeds are for you. Health and nutrition. The Alaskan Malamute and the Siberian Husky have similarities and differences when it comes to their health. Generally, however, the Siberian Husky tends to be healthier than the Alaskan Malamute, as the Malamute's health tends to decline sooner than the Husky. The National Breed Club recommends that both dogs are tested for hip dysplasia, which is an abnormality in the formation of the joints which can cause lameness in the limbs or painful arthritis of the joints. On top of those issues, the Alaskan Malamute is also tested for polyneuropathy, which is a neuro disease that affects the nervous system. Additionally, the Malamute is also more at risk of suffering from von Willebrand's disease, which is caused by a deficiency in the number of particular platelets in his blood. This means that his blood is unable to clot. Chondrodysplasia, also known as dwarfism, can be found in the Malamute, however this is something that can normally be spotted in the first few months of the pup's life. In terms of nutrition, the Alaskan Malamute will consume 4 cups of food a day, whereas the Husky will consume 3 cups of food that's been formulated specifically for active breeds like the Husky. This is generally dependent on size, so if you have a large Husky and a small Malamute, then they may consume the same. But they can definitely pile on the pounds quick if it's not monitored. Price. If you still can't decide between the Alaskan Malamute and the Siberian Husky, then there is one last difference, the price. On average, the Alaskan Malamute is priced at $1,500, whereas the Siberian Husky is priced at $1,000. On top of the initial price, there are other costs to consider, such as the initial setup of having a dog, such as beds, collars, ID tags, and toys, etc., as well as regular veterinarian checkups, medical insurance, the cost of his food, professional grooming, and many other things. Having a dog is a big commitment, and these guys cost a bit more than the average dog across the years. Final thoughts. Both of these guys are simply amazing, and have both an impressive history and a remarkable working career. They really are the best of both canine worlds, hard-working, intelligent pups who also shower you with love and affection when the job is done. The Husky is predisposed to less health issues, requires less grooming, eats slightly less, and the initial cost of him is cheaper. However, the Malamute is more independent, less likely to suffer with separation anxiety, and is more imposing and protective than the Husky. They both need mega amounts of exercise, and will destroy your house and garden if left unstimulated. However, they are both intelligent and pick up commands easily, so if you raise them correctly and maintain their needs, none of this should be an issue. With their wolf-like appearance, but cuter and fluffier, they are head-turners of both humans and other animals alike. The Malamute is much larger, and a better protector due to his guarding tendencies. So if it is a guard dog you are after, then the Malamute is probably the better option. The Husky is a smaller version, but much goofier and chattier than the Malamute. So, if it's a friendly family fiend that you want, then maybe the Husky is the standout choice. When it comes to choosing a canine companion, the question is never which dog is better, but which dog better suits you and your lifestyle. So, the million-dollar question is, which breed has pulled on your emotions and sled straight into your heart? So here we have come to the end of the video. Hope you enjoyed the video. If yes, kindly let us know in the comments. If you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, please do so. See you in the next video.